Teach code. Okay, let's see. We do it like this. Superstar. Yes, you got it. Yes. All right. I just sit here staring aimlessly at the screen. It's like checking my phone too. My phone is always somewhere close by. How you doing?
Pretty good, yourself?
Very good. Thank you for asking. Speaking of phones. All right. It's not one of my kids. That's all I need to know. Okay. So welcome to your very first lesson here at Kenyon's Keys. I hope that what we build here today gives you the confidence to find 100 ways, the confidence to be like, it's never too much, the confidence to just like do the things that you know you want to do with your voice. That's what I'm here for. So based on the notes that I took, oh, wrong notes, turns page.
So you went to the channel.
Yeah, so based on the notes that I took, you play a little bit, but you also sing a lot of old school R&B songs. And the goal here today is to kind of identify the ranges that your voice loves. Like if you can tell by my singing voice, my voice likes a lot of the low stuff, the high stuff, not so much. Can I do it? Yeah, that's not my happy place though. So what we're trying to do is find the happy place for your voice. So it's going to be a lot of call and response. It's going to be some videos that I might bring in and ask you to sing a few vowels. It's going to be you singing to a karaoke track. And then I'm going to give you some pointed tips for how to make it greater later. For how to make it greater later. So without further ado, let me move my notes off the keyboard. And I just want you to give me just a nice little, like pretend like you're fogging up the glass, like. like your breath is hot, your breath is kicking. But that's about how much air I want you to put towards what we're getting ready to sing. You're just gonna go, ah, just a five note descending. Let me move this other camera out of the way. For when I show my keyboard students, this is what your hands do, sweetheart. That's where your hands go. All right, so you're just going to give me a five note. Breathe in through your nose. Everything's going to come out through your mouth. One, two, breathe and sing. Breathe right here. So instead of, are you from Texas?
I'm not from Philly.
I'm from Philly. Okay. A lot of my best friends are from the Philadelphia area. So we have a tendency to like talk this east-west way. I want you to sing your ahs in the north-south. Ha, like put an H on the front of it. Ha, because of you play football, unit football.
Have,
All
yes.
right, think about you're singing in between the goal post. Okay, you want to keep everything inside the goal. There you go. Nice full round sound. One, two. Ready, sing. Again. Yeah, come on with it. Put an H in front of it. Keep going. Put an H in front of it again. Back in the football goal post. I won't kill you, I promise. Relax your face. It's just singing. Relax. Head nice and level. One more just because I'm messing with you. All right. I love what I hear. I love what I hear. So this has, you've got some good range here. We've gone from here to, we've gone up an octave. Yeah, we've gone up an octave. That's some good range there. What that means is you're able to consistently maintain pitch between the span of eight cool notes. Ooh, these magic eight notes, which is great. That's what that translates to. And so some of the tips I was giving you about keeping your head nice and level, a lot of times as the singing gets higher, we want to be like, ah. And it cuts off, the voice box never has, it never has a chance. And oh yes, yo, Walter, how's your water consumption? How many liters you do in a day?
I usually do half my body weight, about 100 to 125.
All right. Okay. Nothing to say there. Good to go. Yes. So what we're gonna focus on this time, we're gonna do the same exercise again. I just want you to realize it's just singing. That's it. Quit thinking so hard. It's okay. Same thing right there. Don't know. Does it help if I'm showing you how I'm moving up the keys?
No,
Do you get
I used to direct choirs, so I can hear where you're going.
cool? Because some people are like, I need to see what's happening. And then I have to keep looking because I forget what key I'm in. As I'm doing these little five little funky notes, and I'm just like, I can't remember what key I'm in right now. I'm in the key of D. So you've gone from the D below middle C to the A above middle C. Octave plus four, octave plus five. One, two, breathe and sing. So this time when you sing it, when it gets to the see if you can put that spin on the end. Make it real nice, full, buoyant, present. One, two, breathe and sing. Breathe right here. Key I was in. Put your hands here and do it. Don't yell, put an H in front of it. Nice and gentle. Two more. Last one, right here. How are you feeling about this?
Pretty good,
Yes. All right, I'm about to pull in this warm up specifically for the male voice because I'm not a male. So I want you to hear a guy giving you some direction. I know, like as a female, what I sing is always going to be it's going to sound an octave higher than what it is I want you to sing. And I don't want you to hear me sing. I want you to hear a guy sing, if that makes sense. All right, cool. So when I pull this in, my picture's going to go away. But I'm still here. I can still see you. I can still hear you.
Okay.
Because it freaks out some of the kids. Oh my God, where did you go, Miss Kenya? Ah! I'm like, I'm right here. I'm right here. I ain't went nowhere, sweetheart. I'm right here. All righty. Jump in when you catch on.
Oh, you
Nice. Once more.
For our patients, for our community.
Let me rewind. And I can't get that low. That's why I'm like, I gotta let him sing it. You're getting into the groove there. All right, let me figure out how to swip swap and bring me back in.
There we go.
Let me switch my audio. Yeah, there we go. Okay, cool. Because sometimes my audio will switch to my whatchamacallit. And then sometimes it'll switch to the thing that I was doing on YouTube. And then sometimes I need to switch back to my laptop. I'd be like, click, click. Okay, yeah, and I'm back. All right. So this is the first time I've used this platform this week with all my students. And it's designed specifically for music. Just to give you a little lay of the land, there's like on the bottom right, there's three dots. So you can change the layout. Mm-hmm. Grid, group left layout, panel left, whatever. Whatever works best for you. Some other things, you can always chat. Sometimes I'll type a link in there. Or if you need to send me a link, you can put it in there as well. And then we can send files back and forth to each other. There's a little whiteboard on there. I don't tend to use that so much with my adults. It's the kids that really want to draw, whatever. Yeah. So that's what this platform is about. And so what I'm going to do is give you everything that we've done today. I'm going to start putting your own little personal timeline of stuff in this other platform. So music.live, which is where we are now, is where we'll do lessons. Musico.io is going to house your own personal library of things that I give you based on what we've worked on. So it might be the vocal exercise we just did. If I come across something real cool, I'll drop it in there if I think it'll help you. Those kinds of things. So let's set that up. And I'm going to go to it. All these dings and stuff you hear, it's usually somebody's mama texting me or calling. That was somebody's mama calling a while ago.
Been there. I didn't say.
And so it's either my kids or the mother or father of somebody else's kids, which is my day. I actually love it, though. I actually love what I do. So not too many people can say that. So I'm going to Musico. I don't need to share audio. And can you still hear me?
Yes.
Perfect. All right. So I'm going to set up an account just for you. I want to make sure I get the right email in here, though. Add student. That was mark.stevens.
No, I'm going with mark.shawn.
How you spell Sean?
S-E-A-N. .stevens. At Gmail.
All right, you're a vocal student, not that it matters. And what's going to happen is it's going to kick out an email click the link in the email, and then you'll have your own little spot. So now I can start adding assignments. So from my personal library, I'm going to come in here and give you something about intervals. Yes, Abe. I'm going to give you something from my personal library. This one, the solfege warm up. Now, if you don't want to sing like all these do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do's, just sing a straight la. Sing a straight la. And these are assignments you can access at any time. You don't have to wait for it to be like lesson day.
Okay.
What I love about Musico is you can record directly in here. So if you have to miss a lesson for whatever reason, you can come in here and record directly. Just click the little microphone right there and follow the prompts. So I've put three assignments in there for you so far. Bing, bam, boom. And whatever we did today, I'm going to come back and put in there as well. So that's a little bit about Musico. Let me come back over here. And again. Bam, back on my laptop. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is talk about your first song you want to sing. Which song do you want to work on first?
Wow, that's a good question. So when I'm singing karaoke and stuff like that, I do Lovely Day or Love Ballad.
Two awesome songs. Two awesome songs. Let me grab my notes. See, these kids ain't raised right these days. All right. So let's see if we can, you know, I'm gonna find a karaoke here somewhere in the land of YouTube. Lovely Day, and make sure this key works for you. Let me bring it in. I want you to sing along to it just so I can check and make sure that this is the key that works for you. My pitch is going to go away, but I'm still here.
Okay.
That's what I'm talking about. Off the top. Let's go.
When I wake up in the morning, love, and the sunlight hurts my eyes, something without warning, love, bears heavy on my mind.
This out. When you're singing day, you're not gonna sing day, you're gonna sing a lovely da. I want you to sing a lovely da.
A lovely da? Okay.
And then when you get ready to end it at the e, a lovely day. Okay. So a lovely da. It sounds weird.
Die.
There you go. That's it. All right, jump in.
When the daily lies ahead of me, it's impossible to fade.
pull back. I was waiting for you to go for the a lovely day. Yeah, I was like, come on.
Is this like, one?
Is this one?
Yeah.
I know. I love how you're freestyling and making it your own. It's not a Bill Withers song. It is now a Mark Stevens song. All right, stand up and rock and roll with it. Here we go. Already better. Goalposts. Put it in between goalposts. I'm gonna pull that back. Put it in between the goalposts. Instead of singing the east, west, north, south, it. Lovely day. Let me pull back from here. You can have a seat. What was that? Wasn't too much work though, was
no,
it?
No, not at all.
Like, I was like, I'm like,
perfect. I mean, like I do that, and then like I said, I hold those notes, but I'm usually doing it like you said, east west.
So let's talk about that. So this is also a matter of a diaphragmatic support issue. So what we got to do is build the endurance under your diaphragm. And I'm going to pull up an exercise specifically for that. They're called Farinelli breathing exercises, if you care about what the name is. But just know that you breathe in for a little bit, you hold it, you blow it out. You breathe in for a little bit longer, you hold it for a little bit longer, you blow it out for a little bit longer. So it's always, this one always cycles in through the nose, out through the mouth for this exercise. Make sure your shoulders are nice and relaxed. Roll your head around a couple of times and go in the opposite direction. Do what makes you feel comfortable. Let me open up a different window, bring in this Farinelli exercise. These are excellent, excellent, excellent for building up that durability and sustainability of the diaphragm. Do you understand how the diaphragm works as a support for singers?
Yes. That it pushes the air through the through the larynx and through the voice box to get whatever notes you're trying to get to.
Yeah, absolutely. This muscle it sits directly underneath your rib cage. And if you want to feel how you can compromise it, you know, not kill yourself, but how you can kind of compromise it, what you do is just kind of make like karate chopping blades, and you're going to stick it directly underneath the rib cage and try to take a deep breath, and you'll see that you cannot.
Oh, yeah.
The diaphragm is extremely important with breathing. And what we're going to do is flex that muscle right now. This is a muscle that doesn't get exercised enough. All right. Farinelli. So we're going to breathe in for four, hold it for four, blow out for four, breathe in for five. Hold it for five, blow it out for five. Always in through the nose, out through the mouth. When you're breathing in, it's not a like, right. You know, like this is the last breath I'll ever take on planet Earth. It's not that. It's just gentle, regular breathing. Here we go.
Farinelli breathing exercise. Inhale for four. Suspend for four. Exhale for four.
Good.
Inhale for five. Suspend for five. Exhale for five. Inhale for six. Suspend for 6. Exhale for 6. Inhale for 7. Suspend for 7. Exhale for 7. Inhale for 8. Suspend for 8. Exhale for 8. Inhale for 9. Suspend for 9. Exhale for 9. Inhale for 10. Suspend for 10. Exhale for 10. Well done.
Oops, I didn't mean to click that. But at which point, at what point was this like, oh, this is super easy? When did it go from being?
Somewhere around 7 or 8. Yeah. Once I realized that I can hold, I mean, that I can breathe in for 7 or 8. So I made my breaths in a little shorter to get to those numbers. And 10 was like surprising. Thought my eyes was gonna start twitching, and when I was holding it, and I'm like,
I love it.
Give him CPR.
Oh man, goodness, I love that. That is a great exercise for you. I can already tell. So this was going to be dropped in your music hole as well. Also, I am recording this. So this will stay in Musi just for you to access. You know, it'll be here. I don't transfer it out of Musi. I'd be transferring stuff all day long. I got too many students. Mm-mm. We ain't doing it. It's going to stay right here. So let's jump back into Lovely Day. And the concept we're focusing on right now is being able to sustain the one where you're like, do y'all mind if I take it up a little bit? A lovely day. That's something you should be able to hold forever. It's in your range comfortably. It is something that if you just let it ring and sing, it's going to knock them out every time. So let's jump back into that. Focusing on the part where you get ready to take it up. Me and doing all the other stuff right before. That's over here. I'm trying to figure out like which window I need to come back to. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're not going to talk about how many windows are open right now. That's not what this is about. Coming back. I'm going to give you some lead up to it.
And the world's all right with me. Oh, just one look at you. And I know it's going to be a lovely day.
Yeah.
Lovely day.
had that feel this time.
Pretty a lot better. I wasn't pushing. I wasn't, you know, jumping at the highest.
That's what I'm talking about. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Do it again. Stand up and sing it this time. Gonna give you some lead up into it. Here's the next thing I want you to try with it. Good. All right, good. The next thing I want you to think about is how sound travels. The way sound wants to move forward. So think about your day as it leaves the inside of your body, travels out through your mouth. Where do you want this day to end up? If you want it to fall flat in front of you, you'll sing it like this. A lovely day. If you want your day to be long and enjoyable, there you go. You want to sing it to all you're focusing your day all the way across the room. Find something to focus on far away. Make a mental picture. Do whatever you need to do to get there because that day needs to go beyond your lips. Let me bring it back. Give you some lead in. Let me know if I'm giving you too many things to think about at one time.
No, this is perfect. This is perfect.
Okay, good. Good, good, good. I love to see that work. Yes. That is so pleasing to me to see you make that progress. So think about when Bill Withers was singing this. This is something that was just already comfortable for him, you know, and this is already something that's already comfortable for you. This is something that's already your go-to song when you're doing karaoke. This is a song that is a crowd pleaser. This is a song that many people of different backgrounds more than likely will know. You know, more often than not, even though some people didn't know who Jay-Z and Beyonce were in one of those piano groups that I'm in. I'm like, y'all tripping. Y'all are really tripping. They were tripping. They were on one today. So here's my next thing for you. When we were doing that A-E-I-O-U exercise earlier, the one that's too low for me to sing was like, hey. Yeah, when you were singing that, what was the shape of your A vowel? And when you were singing A Lovely Day, what was the shape of your mouth for that?
Day. I had a smile.
Now, you do have to modify the shape of vowels for something low and something high. You know, keep that in mind. A lovely day versus a lovely day. So if you find yourself running out of day, modify and be like, add a riff, add a run. Whoa, yeah, every time. Whoa, yeah. Shabba-dabba-dwee, or whatever. What is it? Yeah, what is it that Jodeci and them used to be? Oh no, it's like some riff. Yeah, the oh yeah. That's what I'm about to say. Yeah, the oh yeah. Matter of fact, let's do some warm-ups that are similar to that. I got something for you on that. So this exercise is more about pitch accuracy. You're just going to be singing back and forth between two notes. You're going to be like, yay, or wow, or some vowel with a second vowel. First vowel, second vowel. Let me find that exercise. I be knowing what I be looking for because I know what's going to work for my students. Look at my history. Everybody's different. There we go. Found it. And let me bring it back in over here. Make sure I bring in the right one. Chrome tab, this one. Bam.
The new government after this commercial program has finally made solar panels accessible to everyone.
All right, so jump in on this one when you feel comfortable. Me. You starting to think about it. It's like, oh snap, it's getting high.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I see you thinking about it. You're thinking of it. Like, oh. I don't know if it's ooh or oh, doesn't matter to me. Ooh. That's where we are.
Okay.
There you go. Nice and smooth. Bam. I like these because they don't sound like your standard. They don't. Bam. They don't sound like your standard, like, and now we're going to sing classical music. That ain't what we doing. You know, if I had a student here singing class, we'd be doing some totally different warm-ups. So we're going to jump back into Lovely Day. Back into Lovely Day. What we're going to do here is I want you to do, when you run out of day at the part where you take it up, I want you to think about what riffs and runs can you add there when you run out of day so you can take a breath and not die. You're good at this improvising because I make stuff up every day. I don't know if that's a good thing. There we go. Let me give you some lead into it. You can stand or sit. It doesn't matter this time.
And the world's all right with me. Oh, just want to look at you. And I know it's gonna be a lovely day.
Yes.
A lovely day.
It's all good.
That was the okay. end, I know.
Yeah. I was like, I didn't mean to go to what I was next. Let me come Ooh. Back over to a lovely day. Yeah. Okay. And then another thing I would like for you to do is look at somebody else when they sing this song, the shape of their mouth as they sing it. Mm-hmm. And preferably a male, doesn't have to be a male. Let me see if I can find. I know you hear me tip-tapping.
Yeah, I got to learn to do that because most of the times when I'm doing certain songs, I'll go to Layla because her register is so deep.
I've been told so many times, like, oh my God, your personality is just like Layla. I'm like, oh my God, she's crazy too. This is terrible. I'm like, oh my God. This is not a good thing if she's like me. Oh, the world.
She's something else for
I have friends that are in the band. Do you follow Snarky Puppy by chance?
No.
Okay, Snarky Puppy is a band that started out of UNT. And some people that I went to elementary school and stuff are just people I used to run with. I'm from Dallas, but we moved here from Maryland. So I have like friends who have Grammys and stuff. And I'm just like, you know, I'm over here. They call me to do some things, but I still stay over here. You know, I'm doing my thing, but it's so cool to hear them relay their experience with Layla, or it's really cool for when I'd be like, hey, Mark, I need a guitar lesson. And Mark is like, well, how many guitar chords do you know? And I'm like, 4. And he's like, come back when you know more. And I'm like, oh, okay. I don't know enough guitar lessons to be taking lessons from Mark. Okay, great. I mean, Mark got a Grammy or two. Okay, I'm over here. Mark got Grammy. It's like, no shade, no hate. Let me find this one. Then, you know, you may or may not know this person. Let me see if I can find it. 5 years ago, what was I doing? Let me get back to the lovely day.
Lovely day.
Yeah, it's just too easy for me to sing it up there. For me. I don't even know. Okay, that's all. When did I do this? Look at, like, 2015? Oh, my God. Okay. Wait. My audio. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I put stuff out and I forget about it. And then, look, it comes back full circle. So these are the things I want you to focus on. In Musico, I'm going to drop some things. Everything that we've done today, every exercise we've done, I'm going to put it there so you can access it anytime. I'm also going to find some more material that explains how the diaphragm works and some diagrams that I like visuals. You got to see it. It's like the way that muscle works. It wraps around almost all the way to your spine. Not quite that far. That sucker is huge. It's a big muscle. And the inside of our body is a vacuum. So every time we're breathing in, something has, you know, the diaphragm is like, oh, let me get out the way so I can make some room so you get your lungs can fill up the way they need to fill up. And then every time we're blowing out, the diaphragm's like, let me push this stuff out of you. Let me push it out. So it's good. I want you to see that visual connection between those two. I'm going to give you one more exercise. It's gonna be female led, and I'm kind of on the fence about this one. Let me think about this one. Let me see it. I'm gonna pull it up, and if I change my mind, I'm gonna let you know. I might change my mind. Baby, can I change my mind? Please don't make me beg. It was this one right here. It's probably going to have a commercial in front of it.
All right, all. I want to show.
Mute the commercial. Skip.
Sweetheart.
All right, let me see if I can make her bigger. And this was like a whole workout.
and we're going to do a fantastic warm down and let's go. Lift, twirl.
I'm trying to think if this is in your range. That's what I, that's what I'm on the fence about. Because mm-hmm. you'd be like. It is. Can you do lip trills?
Mm-hmm. I can do it.
Okay. All right. You're going to hear her singing, but sing below her. Let me see what you got before I make up. Yeah.
Use your breath in. Let's go. Keep it supported.
Did you run out of air for that?
No.
Okay. So this is the connection with that. Come back.
This is the connection with that. If you can't keep the lip trill going, the diaphragm is not engaged properly. That's why I like this one. Elbow hitting stuff. So you got this. Versus like a. Yeah, versus something like that. That's like your diaphragm ain't even trying. It's like, are you alive? Let me check your pulse. Kind of thing. I'm gonna bring her back. That's one of those exercises. So I'm gonna put this video in there too. And I only want you to go, I want you to watch the whole thing, but I only want you to do the exercises that make sense to you for now. If it doesn't make sense, we're gonna break it down on next week.
Okay.
All right. So before we're not leaving right now, we still got 7 minutes to work. What other questions can I answer for you? What are the expectations that you have? What is it that you're looking to grow, learn, do, gain? Q&A session.
So some of the stuff that you've already told me kind of just from you singing, I want to be able to be in my wheelhouse where like you were just singing anything. It could be like something from the alphabet and you're just singing it. Like that's my issue. A lot of times it's more of breathing and then just something simple. Like I over sing stuff. Like if you heard me when I stood up and I started Lovely Day, I'm like, day! And it's all out of
And life. I was like, no.
Day. I want to be
there. That's beautiful. Gave me goosebumps. That gave me goosebumps. Gentle. Gentle is the way when it comes to the voice. If anything is ever forced, either you're going to fart or something bad going to happen. either you're going to fart out your mouth with a cracked note or you're going to fart out the vein. It's always gentle with the voice. My kids know that I'm not going to yell at them. If they hear me whispering, they know they behind is grass. You know, if I'm whispering, they in trouble. Mommy not going to mess up her pretty. I got one that's a senior on the football team. I have never yelled for my son. Go, Mouse. I'm protecting the pretty. So if there's a soldier that needs to be knifed and talked to, whisper. Mind games. What else?
Just like you said, I know I was singing some songs that were probably a little bit out of my range. Glenn Jones. Who else?
I've Been Searching is in the key of, let me look it up. See if it's in here.
You know, the reason I used to sing that is because you know it gets the girls. So I'm like, you never know just what you got till you let it slip away. You know,
yeah, ask me how I got my first husband. Yeah,
I will never be the same.
True I will never be the same. Gentle, if anything is forced, oh man,
yes,
I'm probably trying it faster. Okay, I've Been Searching is in what key? I've Been Searching, Glenn Jones key.
It's an A flat. Yeah, it's an A flat. Oh, I'm not going to Spotify. I'm not clicking that.
That sound like some of my favorite gospel singers, Tony and what was my man's name? Just passed away. Sings
Rance Allen.
No, Sunday. If Sunday breaks, Sunday comes.
When Sunday comes,
don't forget it. Don't give up on Jesus. Don't give up on Jesus. Hey. Oh, I can't remember his name.
Hi.
I can't remember his name, but yeah. He just passed away, and Tony did his
It won't give me a name. Daryl Coley?
Daryl Coley, that's it.
Daryl Coley died? I ain't know that. I wonder if my husband know that.
Yeah, Daryl Coley passed away.
Look, gospel is my husband's wheelhouse. Right. He been knowing all them people now.
Yeah, that's my boy.
My God.
I'd be praying. I'd be like, Lord, can I just get like 75% of what Tony could do, Lord? This is ridiculous.
Yeah, my husband is usually like, I call on, he calls on Jesus a lot because he married me. That's how my husband puts it. I'm like, you know, you don't want to say it, I do. I said I do too, but you know, hey, we're.
My prayer life is ramping up because I want to be married. I understand.
I'm
going to pray for him.
Yeah. Pray for the brother. Pray for brother James Battle in his time of need. He knows who he married. It's all good. You want to be, do you have everything all planned?
Like what? No. Okay.
It'll come to you. I'm not going to drop nothing for you. It'll come to you. It'll come. So what else can I answer for you?
Now you give me some good stuff to work on. Keep it in the goalposts. I wrote that down. Try to work on that. Really, is you said everything should go through the nose, breathing wise. Is that right? Is that correct?
For that exercise we're doing, yes. Okay. I don't always breathe through my nose.
Okay.
I don't, because sometimes I need to hurry up and get some air, and the nose ain't gonna get it.
Right.
The nose ain't. But for that Farinelli exercise, in through the nose, out through the mouth, when you're singing, it's probably going to be something different. It just depends on the song.
Okay.
That's a good question.
And other than Lovely Day, is there any other song that you know that's like right in my register that I need to, that I might want to practice or play with?
Oh, Luther Never Too Much, for sure. That's in your range, as it is. If you want a challenge, Frankie Beverly, Before I Let Go.
One of my favorites.
All right. If you want to do something else by Frankie, We Are One.
Oh, I love that too.
Let's see. A gospel song in your range would be... I don't know these people's names. Let me look at my playlist for church. Hold on.
I told my cousin, I said, hey, your mother cannot pass away right now. She said, why is that? I said, because I can't complain or suffering right now, okay?
Look, my daddy already told us.
Four funerals.
I've played a couple of my grandparents' funerals. I had an uncle that was, his funeral was yesterday. I didn't go. I mean, if it's in Dallas, if it's not like somebody in my house, I'm probably not going in the house that I grew up. I'm just not going because it'd be too much. Take My Hand, Precious Lord.
Okay.
Fred Hammond, We're Blessed in the City.
Yeah, I do that.
Don't stay away from Israel. Like, rejoice in the Lord always. Stay away from that. That's not where your range is for where he sings it. Let me look at another playlist for church.
You could take, if you want to do like one, not an old 100 per se, but like an old one that's a rocker, Walk With Me, Lord. You can put that anywhere you want. Walk with me, Lord. Walk with me. You can put that anywhere you want. And a musician, a church musician, should be able to pick you up. That follows a formula. Let me see. What's another one?
Walk with me. Okay.
Possibly I give myself away.
Okay. That's
one you gotta give myself away. So this one is, what key do I have this one in right here? Can't see.
So let me ask you a question, that last question though. The keys. It's best to know my keys because the person could easily put me out of where I'm at. Okay.
Absolutely.
I was at karaoke the other day down in Austin, and I'm almost certain he put Luther Vandross' House Is Not a Home at least one or two, which comes above what I was used to.
Yeah, that'll wreck everything.
Yeah,
there's no way to recover
stuff. And I was like, "What? I'll just say that."
There is no way to recover if it's not in the best key for you. Yeah. It happens all the time. Watch anybody sing the Star Spangled Banner and flop. That one has to be set in the right place, for sure. Because number one, that song's got a wide range, but it has to be in the key that works best for you. So one of my best tools is for when if I have to sing and play, and you know how to read lead sheets, yes?
Yes.
All right. So this is the Guitar Tabs. That's the Guitar Tabs app. And it just gives me the chords. And when I need to transpose for whomever, if it's me or somebody else, I just transpose. I ain't got time. I can transpose in my head, but sometimes I don't have time to think it through. Transpose over here and I'm good to go. I can put it where I need to put it for whoever. Yeah, you got some good work there.
Thank you. I enjoy
it. It's a pleasure. Always. I'll see you same bat time, same bat channel next week.
Thursday at 1.
All right. Take care, Mark. It was a pleasure.
Yeah, talk to you soon.
Bye.